Okay, good morning. Good morning out there. It is Wednesday, April 1st, 2020, 9:19 a.m. Pacific time. I hope you're doing well. Just wanted to do a little video here and maybe hopefully I can be of some encouragement. I've already done some praying this morning and gotten into the Word. Hope that you have too. And if you don't believe in God, then hopefully maybe you'll be drawn to God during this time. Because He's really waiting. He's really given people a chance to repent and come to Him. It's what God does is He gives. That's why He hasn't sent Jesus back yet, is He wants more people to come to know Him, to know His Son Jesus Christ. So He's given the world time to repent for those who are going to survive this pandemic. You know, God is not the author of evil and death and everything. That's the devil's job. He goes around seeking whom he may devour. The devil does. And Jesus Christ defeated him on the cross. But there's things, you know, things I don't understand in the Bible. And I just pray that you would be drawn to God and come to Him and be saved and confess that He's Lord and ask Him to forgive you for your sins. Now, the president had a press briefing yesterday, and yesterday on my last video last night, I said that I thought it was a very good press briefing because for one thing, what's his name from CNN was fairly nice for a change. But the more I think about it and the more I hear people talking about this projection of these thousands and thousands of people dying in America, 100,000 to 250 or something, 240 or some thousands. I don't believe that has to happen, okay? I don't believe that. Look, let's just do what we need to do and crack down on it and get into place, fall into line. Everybody do what we're supposed to do and do it well and survive this thing and hurry up and get this the heck over with, okay? And we don't have to project that all these thousands, hundreds and thousands of people have to die in America, okay? That's just their scientific doctor, you know, that's the way they see that it could happen. So, but it doesn't have to happen. If we do our part and we pray, the church gets off their lazy butts and prays more. Pray for people to get through this with less anxiety. I've been praying this morning already, coming against every conceivable thing I can think of to pray against. Okay? And so, I know I'm yelling this morning. I'm very sorry about that. But, Lord, I lift it up to you. I lift it up to you. I thank you for your word. I thank you for your peace. I thank you for stopping this coronavirus. Satan, I bind you in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray for peace over people, that they would have peace. I come against all this anxiety of readjusting our lifestyles to every conceivable thing we do in the house and outside of the house. Help the youth, Lord. Help the youth. Just fall in line and let's get this done and over with, and hold the communist China accountable for anything that they could be, would be, have done to unleash this hell and this horror on America. We don't hate Chinese people. We're talking about a system over there. And wakey wakey, who knew? It's just like when we went into Afghanistan, who knew that the women over there, and still are, and God bless them, they have to live by certain rules according to certain religions with covering their faces and everything. Who knew that though? So we find out things when these kinds of things happen. Who knew that the Chinese Communist Party, I think, has control over every aspect of their lives, possibly. Okay, so we're going to do more research. We don't hate Chinese people. I love Chinese people. You go back to my videos and you'll find out that I've been praying for the precious Chinese people that this hit from the very beginning. And what you don't know about my videos is because of the social media shadow banning and deleting and all this crap, they act like the Chinese Communist Party. And for so long, they did this stuff to Americans. Because they're used to, you know, appeasing the Chinese Communist Party over there. So they decide that they think that they can do it to Americans. Well, they have done it to Americans. They've gaslit us, okay? The internet and the social media companies have gaslit America. Okay, so then when we go to speak out about anything like this, and even, you know, I can detect it in some of the politicians when they think that if we come against the Communist Chinese Party, they're equating that to, well, somebody's gonna like hate Chinese people in America, and no, don't do that. That's stupid. Stop it. Don't you dare persecute Chinese or Asian people. Don't you dare. Okay, you know, stop it. Stop all racism. And, you know, hateful for Jews and Christians. And even Muslims, we've got to be careful that we Christians don't come off as haters of Muslim people. They can't help that they're in this system, okay? Oh, ye Christian. And I'm not defending anything here. I'm just saying, when somebody has not come to Christ yet, when somebody's out there living their lives and they don't know that they're even a sinner because they're just living in sin and they haven't got the message yet, like I didn't, you know, but it doesn't help to condemn people. Yes, we can point out what sin is, but what sin is to one person at one certain time in their life is to another different, okay? Because God will take us from stage to stage. He knows we're but dust. He knows we are fragile. And we couldn't help, you know, maybe smoking a cigarette is sin to one person at one time, but it's not a sin to the other person, because they've not arrived to this different, you know, arrival of the other person. So God is gentle. He knows how much we can take on accepting conviction and letting him take something, letting him deliver us from something. Okay, so he's very gentle in most cases. What happens is if we intentionally walk outside of his will in rebellion and defiance, he says, well, I can't protect you, sweetie, because the devil's out there already wants to ravage you. And if you walk outside of my umbrella of protection, I'm sorry, honey, but I can't protect you. He will protect us for a certain man in ignorance, okay? But we've got to do our part, okay? That's why we exercise. We've got to exercise so that we can, you know, keep our blood flowing and work out our heart. You know, we got to do our part as people on this earth, okay? And then he'll do his part too. And sometimes, most of the time, he'll do his part before we even know how to do our part better. I mean, he's long-suffering God, okay? So, you know me, I make these videos spontaneous so that if he wants to talk, he can talk and use my voice without me pre-planning. I'm going to talk about A, B, C, and D here. Now, I don't want to get critical on that because he might have me do that someday. Let's talk. That might be actually better for me. People could understand me better. So I might do that someday. I don't want to be too critical of that. But you know me, generally, and for the most part, these videos are spontaneous. And so I'm also learning how to do a video without my Bible right here. I love reading the Bible. It's really my GPS system for my brain. And I deal with ADD, okay? Some people don't even believe in ADD. Okay, I don't want to get into that right now. But I do come against anxiety during this time, and heart attacks and stroke and suicide and aneurysms. And get up and do your exercises. I'm just a coach, okay? I don't have any degree or anything in anything, but I do coach somebody in work and in physical exercise and music. So anyway, I'm gonna let you go now. Have a really good day. God bless you, protect you and your family, and pray over your family and your friends, your loved ones, and the cities and states in America and your country. If you're watching this from another country, I'm praying for you, okay? Because this is Morningstar International. Morningstar, Jesus Christ, the bright and morning star, who will outlast them all. His light will never be put out. And so his light lives in us and through us. And he's the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, and his mercies are new every morning. I love you. God bless you. Read the Bible, okay? Get into the Bible. Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, Acts, all the epistles, Psalms and Proverbs. Pray the Psalms, okay? The enemy in the Psalms used to be a physical enemy in the Old Testament. It is the devil, okay? He's the enemy of us all. This pandemic, this coronavirus, is the enemy of us all, and we crush and defeat him by praying against him and taking authority over it, and also doing our part to stay inside. We can do this. I pray for God to meet all of your needs, food, money, bills paid, in Jesus' name. Okay, love you, and God bless. Have a good day, okay? Bye-bye.